Good morning, and welcome to today's edition of Stephen Whiteside's Stock Market Timing Television. Each day at this time, Stephen takes a technical look at the markets, including the S&P 500, NASDAQ, gold, crude oil, as well as the most widely held leveraged ETFs. This video is a production of TheUptrend.com and is for information and educational purposes only. The views and opinions expressed in this presentation are those of Stephen Whiteside and should not be considered personal investment advice. Always consult a qualified financial advisor before making any investment decisions. To learn more about the charts featured in this presentation, please visit TheUptrend.com. And now, here is Stephen Whiteside with today's video newsletter.
Good morning, Stephen Whiteside here with your daily market outlook for Wednesday, October 7th, 2009. In the pre-market this morning, not a lot's going on. Futures are just around fair value. Gold is up in the pre-market this morning, but off its overnight highs, currently trading just under $1,050. Starting off this morning, looking at our 60-minute charts, while we were up yesterday and we're still projecting higher prices for the S&P 500, we did have a nice big early warning signal show up on Tuesday's chart. Now, we ended up closing right at resistance at a price target, and our next price target, if the market does want to move higher on Wednesday, is 1,062 on the S&P 500 cash index. For the S&P itself, if we start closing below 1045 on an hourly basis on Wednesday, that would give us an intraday sell signal, and we are expecting to get a sell signal on Wednesday. Looking at the NASDAQ 100, we're looking for an hourly close below 1690 on Wednesday to give us a new intraday sell signal. For the SOX index, we're looking for an hourly close below 315. For the XAU, nice big spike yesterday, but then early warning signal showed up. We're still trading under 175, major resistance at 175 for the XAU. On Wednesday, we're looking for an hourly close below 167 on the XAU to give us a new intraday sell signal for gold stocks. Now, oddly enough, most of the major indexes ended up in a very neutral position, right very close to the hourly flypaper channel. There's the NASDAQ 100, there's the SOX index, and there's the VIX. So Tuesday's trading activity actually turned out to be fairly neutral. And so we're right in no man's land, looking for a breakout or a breakdown for these indexes. For the VIX, VIX is on an intraday sell signal, which corresponds with an upward movement in the stock market. And so for confirmation on Wednesday, if the VIX starts trading above 26.50 while we've got the stocks going lower, we would expect the stock market to continue to move lower on Wednesday with an hourly close above 26.50 on the VIX. Looking at the daily charts, we've got gold and gold stocks up at the top of the list, and we've got the VIX and the US dollar down at the bottom of the list on Wednesday. Looking at the XAU, looking at the daily charts, big up move yesterday corresponds with a new buy signal if anybody wanted to take it. I'm certainly not going to take it. Looking for a daily close below 160 if you want to go back to shorting this market. Looking for at gold, we need a daily close below 1,000 on Wednesday to give us a new daily sell signal. Looking at T-bonds, the 30-year Treasury bonds, we need a daily close below 132.50. Now, we got up and we hit our first price target, got pretty close to hitting our second price target. So you should have already got rid of some of your bond position, and we're looking for that exit signal to get out, totally kicked out of that position. Looking at the NASDAQ 100, we need a daily close above 1713 on Wednesday to give us a new daily buy signal. For the S&P 500, we're looking for a daily close just above yesterday's close, just above 1055. Looking at the natural gas, we're looking for a daily close below 462 on Wednesday to give us a new daily sell signal. For bank stocks, we're looking for a daily close above 130 on the S&P Bank Index. For chips, we need a daily close above 325. For crude oil, we're looking for a daily close below 68.50. For copper, we're on a new daily buy signal for copper. A daily close below 342 would give us a sell signal on Wednesday. And looking at the VIX, a daily close below 25 on Wednesday would give us a new daily sell signal, and that should correspond with a daily buy signal for the S&P 500. And looking at the U.S. dollar, a sharp move down yesterday, sharp move up in most of the currencies around the world. We covered currencies in another presentation. For the U.S. dollar, we're looking for a daily close above 77.40 on Wednesday to give us a new daily buy signal. Okay, that's all for Wednesday morning. I won't be in on Thursday. I'm having chelation treatment on Thursday. And so the next time you'll hear my voice will be on Friday. And so have a great day, and we'll talk to you again on Friday morning.
That was Stephen Whiteside with today's edition of Stock Market Timing Television. For more information on our charts and services, please visit theuptrend.com.